I think it's finally time. Arch Linux, the distro that we all secretly love. The distro with the most toxic community that there is out there. And pretty much the only distro that I actually really like. Now don't get me wrong, Fedora, Solus, Ubuntu, Debian, all those are really good distros. But there's just one thing about Arch that, I don't know, I really like it, you know? But one of the problems that I have with Arch, and that probably everyone has with Arch, is that there is not an actual installer. There is only the command line manual installation of Arch. There's not a GUI installation or even a text-based terminal installation. So you can't recommend this to a beginner that has never installed Linux before. There are some scripts that help you install Arch, but they are still really hard to actually use and install. Now I'm not talking about other distributions like Arco or Black Arch or Arch Labs and all that. I'm talking about pure Arch Linux ISO, the vanilla ISO, just some scripts that you install afterwards. They won't know how to do this, you know? But recently, there has been a change. So let's actually start talking about it. So Arch Linux has a script that's called Arch Installer. And that's what Packstrap uses, or at least I think don't really share that. And so some people realized that they could just take the script and change it, but still use it as the Arch installer script. And that means that you get a text-based installation. Super simple, super easy, with numbers, so it up, let's say, for language 21, for English US, and then the mirrors, and which disk you want to use and all that, and then it will automatically install the system and packstrap it and install grub and all that. And to actually use it, it's super easy. The only thing you have to do is just boot up your Arch ISO and then uninstall the original Arch installer, clone the GitHub repository, and then replace it. And then of course run it. Now don't get me wrong, this is still hard for a beginner, but with the proper documentation I think that's gonna be super easy, because most of the commands are just copy and paste, and the installer is not really bad. I think that every complete noob will somewhat understand how to actually install, but the thing is that it doesn't work. At least on my system, I've tried this 3 times now, and it just doesn't want to install. It installs, and when I try to boot, just grab rescue error. So I'm not sure if this is a problem with my system or not. It automatically installed the NVIDIA drivers, because I actually told it, yeah, if you found the drivers, then yeah, go ahead and install them. And I've selected the proper disks and proper configurations and all that, but I don't know. And I had to actually get Arch installed on my system. So what I ended up doing was to install it the manual way, which of course takes like 45 minutes to an hour and a half. It took me like 28 minutes or something. Yeah. With the help of Arch 5, of course. And then, yep, the system was installed, and I was able to test that Garon 40 and do all the other stuff that I had to do. And by the way, where is Fedora 34? Where is it? And so, yeah, I can see what they're going for. But right now, it doesn't really work, because I've seen loads and loads of videos on YouTube saying how awesome it is, and I can't really agree with them, because, at least for me, it didn't even work. Now, I'm not sure if the actual Arch install script, the new one, the one that I used, is actually made by the people who maintain Arch, or just from a third party group or something, or individual. I have zero idea, but I think that if they are planning on including this as a second way of installing Arch and the official Arch ISO is being released every couple of days, then I guess that they really need to change how it works, because as I said, for me, it doesn't work. And if a complete beginner tries Linux with that ISO and with that method, and it doesn't actually install, then they probably won't ever use Linux again. At least not for a good couple of years. Anyway, I'll leave the GitHub project down in the description, where you can go ahead and check it out and support them and actually try it out for yourself. And if you do actually go ahead and try it, make sure to let me know how it went for you, down in the comment section again. Now I know that this is a shorter video and an unexpected video. I am still working on my Lenovo IdeaPad Chromebook Duet video and review, but this is gonna have to wait actually because of some problems that I have with editing. But yeah, that would be it. Have a good one. Peace out. Just seven, five, six, 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 seven, five